friends, musician friends, always held the highest regard to Paul's musical talent and ethic. In my opinion, he was a musical genius, and it's manifest in his violin playing, which we were fortunate to post on YouTube. So any of you who wants to go and see young Paul Katti play on YouTube, it's there. There's a few selections, music by Bach and Mozart and Debussy and Bartok. He was outstanding, and one of the things that marked him was his ability to distinguish one composer from another. He was absolutely unique, so was his energy as a musician. I have dedicated my violin concerto to him. He was actually sitting next to me while I was composing the themes for the first and second movements, and I'm intentful to complete the composition, which is his also. Without him, it would not have been composed. We would like to present a selection. The work was not composed for Paul, it was composed for someone else, but he loved it. It's called Lullaby, and when I made the arrangement, the transcription for violin, that particular violin part transcription has been dedicated to Paul. With me today is another all-time friend,
Thank you so much, Ron. That was absolutely beautiful. But one thing about Ron that you may or may not know is that aside from being one of Paul's best friends, he also happened to be the most active friend. And he was always calling Paul and coming to visit Paul. And Paul would always tell me how much he loved you. So you're the only person in the music business he trusted. Except for David Siegel.
You know.
Not that David Siegel, the violin maker.
He was the only one I trusted also.
Okay. I trusted him also. So I see, you know, the front row is completely empty. No one really came up. Do you want to come up? Okay, we are. You can break the ice. This is Judy, Paul's cousin.
Teasing. He had a beautiful spirit. He had a sparkle which just lit up a room. And he was just fun to be around our whole childhood. And I have something for my sister that she wanted me to read. Okay, this is for my sister Lisa. I very much wish that I could be with you tomorrow, today, to honor and remember Paul. I will be there in my heart and spirit. I will always and forever remember the awe of listening to Paul play music when I was a child. And a young adult. He was an inspiration for me as a violinist and as a person sending love to everyone. And I want to read something for my son, who is in Europe and couldn't be here. Paul is a kind man who had a difficult life. He had amazing moments of happiness, which we all must remember. He was a very talented musician and brought me joy when he performed with Bill at my bar mitzvah. Paul brought friendship and kindness to all of us. We must remember this and be thankful that he is resting peacefully now in a better place.
Paul on several occasions, and the one thing that has stuck I've had in my mind is the barn Paul had with his big brother, Phil. We would walk through the park, Phil, myself, and my husband with our dogs, and on many, many occasions, Paul would call just to check in and let his brother know he was doing okay. And I know it made Phil feel good. A lot of times, well, maybe it was an inconvenient time to talk to him, but Phil never refused that call. He always took his little brother's phone call. I also remember a time when Paul was at Phil's home, and the two brothers gave the most beautiful concert together, Paul on violin and Phil on the piano. And I just wanted to express my sympathies to the family and especially to you, Phil, on this very sad occasion. But again, the world was made better by a wonderful violinist, and I hope you all enjoyed him as much as I did, oh, even though I only heard him play the one time and then again this evening.
If you don't come up, I'm going to have to call on you. I hate to use Tanisha, but you have one. You knew I was going to get you. That's what happens if you don't volunteer, you get kidnapped.
that counselor didn't know that it was a hamster. And it got out of the bucket we left it in, and someone said it so it was so heartbreaking to tell the mom that that could happen. But he actually took it really well. He had fish, luckily, to soothe it. But he was just so enjoyable. He played for us at the office. He played for us at our Christmas parties, our Thanksgiving parties. We had a movie night and he played for us. He was just so personable. And for every time that he did something to drive me crazy, he did 5 things to make me smile. So he was just an amazing person. And I wish I got to see him more. Unfortunately, I only got to see him when I visited Hazel House after he moved here. But he was a good person. And he'll be nice.
Allison, your daughter is my Melinda, you're next.
Thank you. my name is Tanya. I work at TSI. I work at TSI night shift, overnight shift. Paul and I were friends. He waited for me every night at the desk. He knew what time I was coming. He knew what time I was leaving. He called all night long from 12:30 to maybe about 3. He would come down at 6 for his meds. I would promise I would speak to him in the morning. He would not forget. He would come back out of the glass, sweetheart, it's time to talk. I would sit there, listen to him talk. Most of all, I will remember, he always wanted me to meet him at the gate to take me to Marshall's. He wanted to buy me everything. He wanted to take me to Victoria's Secret. For me not to talk to Bill when he comes. If Bill talks to me, tell him I don't know Paul. And I will always remember Paul. It will never be the same coming to work on Friday nights and Saturday nights. And I can say I was truly hurt when I heard he passed. And I can speak for every staff member at TSI. We all will miss Paul. We've been trading stories since it happened, and we will always remember him, and I'm happy to meet him.
I am Bethany Ferguson, and Paul was my introduction to TSI. When Opportunity Self-Help was open, Marguerite Gale, because I'm a choreographer, felt that maybe I should take care of Paul, and it was the most amazing experience. That was the first musician that a choreographer ever got along with. He was amazing. I mean, we used to put the radio on, and people used to listen to all types of music. So one day he decided to spoof. A hip-hop song would come on, and he'd pluck the violin. He would just pluck it, and eventually he would start to play different tunes. And we had these amazing conversations. We both had traveled extensively in Europe and whatever, and we just shared war stories, artistic stories, and then we fought. Okay, we would have incredible fights, which was just as juicy as the amazing conversation. So when I did get the news that he was gone, that was a major, major hole for me, because I thought back to 2008 when I first met him, and I'll see him again. I know that. Thank you.